Appointment with Fear. This is your storyteller, the man in black. Here again to bring you another story in our series, Appointment with Fear, starring Marius Goring. It's a famous story from the black books of old Spain, of a prisoner in the grasp of the Inquisition. And while we take you into a strange dungeon to be shadowed by an even stranger menace, we trust we shall keep our promise to bring you an appointment with fear. Edgar Allan Poe's story, The Pit and the Pendulum, adapted for broadcasting by John Dickson Carr.
I was sick. Sick unto death with that long agony. And when at length they unbound me and I was permitted to sit, I felt that my senses were leaving me. The sound of the inquisitorial voices seemed merged in one dreamy, indeterminate hum.
Captain Jean d'Orbe.
Yet,
Jean d'Orbe.
For a while I saw, but with how terrible an exaggeration. I saw the soft, nearly imperceptible waving of the sable draperies on the walls of the room. I saw the flames of the 7 tall candlesticks which burned on the table. I saw the lips of the black-robed judges. And these lips appeared to me white, white as paper, white as horror. I saw them writhe with a deadly locution. I saw them fashion the syllables of my name.
Jean d'Albret, Captain Jean d'Albret.
Good fathers, gentlemen.
We hear you, my son.
I have been confined for many months in a dungeon. I have been tormented by nightmares.
Of conscience one trusts.
Pray silence, Fray Antonio.
Even now I have no knowledge of where I am or to whom I may be speaking.
You are speaking to me, my son. I am Fra Pedro d'Espila, prior of the Dominicans of Segovia and Grand Inquisitor for all Spain.
Is this the court of the Inquisition?
It is.
Then God help me.
He will help you, my son, if you trust him.
But I am a French officer.
That is true. A soldier and creature of the archfiend Napoleon Bonaparte.
But a French officer, nonetheless. A prisoner of war. By what right do you try me in this court?
Let the clerk read the charges against this prisoner. Pray silence while the clerk reads the charges.
The charges against the prisoner are as follows. Imprimis, that he is one Jean d'Albret, a captain of artillery in the army of Bonaparte, so-called Emperor of the French.
This means nothing. As the prisoner says, it is no crime. Proceed.
Item, that on the 4th day of September in the year of our Lord, 1808, the said Jean d'Albret did wed, espouse, and marry that most noble lady, the Donna Beatrice Valdez, niece and ward of the illustrious...
One moment.
Your Excellency spoke.
Fray Antonio, was any cheat employed to trap this girl into marriage against her will?
No. We have no actual evidence of any cheat.
Was the girl of age?
I believe so.
Then wherefore is the prisoner here? This marriage was a deplorable thing, if you like. Bonaparte himself is almost at the gates of Madrid. His general Lasalle menaces our city of Toledo itself. But lawful marriage, however regrettable, is no sin or crime.
There are other matters in the indictment, I think.
Then continue. But give us nothing that is not material.
Item, that on the 12th of October, 1808, the said Jean d'Albret, being in command of a 5-gun battery of light artillery, did direct the fire of his guns against the Holy Church of St. Martha the Innocent, and thereby of his wicked malice destroyed the church utterly.
Captain d'Albret, is this charge true?
Yes,
you admit it?
Good father, hear what I have to say. The church blew up, I think.
Would you boast of your sin, young man?
It blew up because it was stored with kegs of gunpowder for your army. I had every right to fire on it.
And that is all the defense you have to make?
I tell you I had every right to fire on it. By military law.
Is military law above God's law?
I don't know. I did my duty. Long live the Emperor.
Captain Dalbray, hear the sentence of this court. Had your offense been any except this, the Holy Office would have been merciful. Mark what I say. No man, however great his heresy, is ever condemned to be burnt in the fire.
The fire.
The fire.
The fire.
If he first recant and acknowledge the error of his ways. But for you, Jean Delbray, there can be no mercy, no pity, no atonement. The only sentence of this court can be...
Death.
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 The secular or government arm to which we must release you has devised two ways of punishment in cases such as yours. You hear the tolling of bells?
I hear them.
It is the procession of the condemned going to the altar de la fe.
Soon the yellow light of the flames will stream through the windows.
And flicker on floor and ceiling.
Nunc et in hora mortis in manus tuas, Domine.
Most of those condemned, out of mercy, will be strangled before they are burned. It cannot be so with you, Jean Dalbray. You must die in one of two ways. Either with the direst physical agony...
A slow fire of green wood. Iced bandages about the head and heart. So that the fire does not approach too quickly.
Be silent, Fra Antonio.
I cry your pardon, Grand Inquisitor.
Or else, Jean Dalbray, you must die in a certain other way.
Have done with this. Pass your sentence and let me go.
The law does not permit me to tell you now what this other way is. It must approach you slowly and force itself into your mind. It must stalk you like a tiger. It must bring you face to face at last with the King of Terrors. The sentence of this court, therefore...
I had swooned. Yet still I will not say that all of consciousness was lost. In the deepest slumber, no. In delirium, no. In a swoon, no. In death, no. Even in the grave, all is not lost. There are shadows of memory which tell me indistinctly of tall figures that lifted me and bore me in silence down, down, still down, until a hideous dizziness oppressed me at that descent into the earth. There was a vague horror at my heart because of that heart's unnatural stillness. Then this consciousness swam back to my wits again. Darkness. A stone floor. And darkness.
Oh, Beatrice. Oh, my wife.
Did you call me, Jean?
Beatrice. Was that you who spoke?
Yes, Jean.
You? Here? In the dungeons of the Inquisition?
I am not really speaking to you, my poor Jean. I am only in your imagination.
Am I mad, then?
No, but your brain is fevered. You only think you hear me.
I hear you clearly, as clearly as I once heard you.
In the little church near the Ebro, where we were married.
Yes, I destroyed that church, Beatrice. I had to. It was my commanding officer's order.
I know, Jean. Be comforted. There are those who care.
You won't leave me.
As long as I am in your heart.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.